Hi, I'm Nico. I'm a fourth-year PhD student working with Victoria de Sousa. And as part of my research project, I often use human cells. And the best way to work with human cells is in a tissue culture hood like this one. The key to working with human cells and tissue culture in general is to keep a sterile working environment. So as part of that, anything that goes into the hood needs to be sprayed down with ethanol. And it's also important that once you're inside the hood, that whatever you touch doesn't touch any of the surfaces and you only touch the things you actually want to be on the cells. What we'll be doing today is a basic cell passaging procedure. Cell passaging is important for taking your cells, which keep on growing on the plate, and diluting them so they don't overgrow and die. The quick overview of what happens there is you wash the existing cells, you loosen them from the plate, and dilute them onto a new plate and fresh medium. If we're working with tissue culture, one of the most important things is to keep a sterile working environment. So before touching anything inside the hood, it's important to spray everything down with ethanol. So we use 70% ethanol. And I'm just going to quickly spray everything down in here that I'll be using. I'm going to wipe it up to make sure no residual ethanol gets in my way. And similarly, everything I will need inside the hood also needs to be sprayed down with ethanol. So all of my various serological pipettes that I'll be using, I'm spraying down. And all of the reagents I'll be using, I'll be spraying down. Okay, now that everything is sprayed down, it's inside the hood, and we're ready to bring our cells into the hood and start splitting them. Before I passage cells and go into the hood, I like to take a peek at the cells under a microscope first. That'll tell me A, if they're still alive and doing well, and B, it'll tell me how confluent the cells are. So I take a peek at these, and these cells appear to be about 95% confluent, which is a good time to split them. Ideally, you want to split them between about 80% and 100% confluency, because if they get too confluent, you run the risk of the cells growing in layers, and they'll get sick and potentially even die. Looking at these cells, they appear to be about 90 to 95% confluent, and basically what I'm looking at here is this area over here is all growing cells. And these areas here and here, those are areas of the plate where cells are not yet growing. And percent confluency just is a measure of the proportion of the plate covered by living cells, which in this case, judging by only the few areas of empty plate, is about 90 to 95%. Now that all of the reagents are in here and the cells are in the hood, it's time to start splitting them. You'll notice I cleared out a working area to have things less cluttered. That's important because you don't want to be bumping into anything as you move around, and it just keeps everything more sterile if you have this nice open working area. So step one is to get rid of the old medium that is on these cells currently. This old medium is at this point nutrient poor and has some dead cells floating in it, so it's important to get rid of that first. So I take this aspirating pipette and use a three-finger technique to just open the lid a little bit, tilt the plate a little bit, and aspirate out the old media without touching the bottom of the plate. I'm done with this pipette now, so I move it far out of the way so it won't get in the way of any future work. Next step is to wash these cells to make sure any remaining dead cells are gone and any other sort of contaminants are gone. I do this using 1x PBS. And before using any tubes, I like to pre-loosen the lid, because when I'm working on it with one hand, it'll make my life a lot easier. I take this 5 milliliter pipette, open the cap completely, flip it upside down to prevent contamination, take the tube, take 5 milliliters of PBS, immediately reseal the tube to prevent contamination, and carefully pipette it into the plate. And I pipette down slowly to prevent any cells from lifting off the bottom of the plate. Okay. I'm now done with this pipette, so I'll move it out of the way. These cells, I'll give them a quick swirl to make sure they're fully washed, and then aspirate out the wash buffer as before. Again, three-finger technique, open it just a little bit, carefully slide in the aspirating pipette without touching the bottom of the plate. All of the healthy cells are currently still on this plate and they're attached to the bottom of the plate via extracellular proteins. So the way to lift the cells off of the plate is to digest those extracellular proteins using trypsin. Loosen the cap, take a 1 milliliter pipette, including tip, open the cap, flip it around, take 1 milliliter of trypsin, close the tube, and add the trypsin in a dropwise fashion, or close to a dropwise fashion, to make sure it gets good coverage on the entire plate. Discard the used tip. And now this sits there for 2 to 3 minutes, either in the hood or it can go back into the 37 degree incubator. After about a minute, I like to prep the next plate that the cells will be split onto. So I take a clean plate from this stash, and each plate should be labeled with a few different things. For one, there should be either your initials on it or some sort of identifier who they belong to. You want to indicate what type of cells there are. In this case, it's human embryonic kidney cells, abbreviated HEK. The dilution we are doing, in this case, we'll be doing a 1 to 20 dilution, and I'll cover what that means in a minute. You want to keep track of how often the cells have been passaged. The old plate was passage 4, so the new plate will be passage 5. And you want to add today's date so that when you come back, you know exactly when these cells were last touched. A 1 to 20 split basically means that you take the original cells and dilute them by 20-fold onto this new plate. Since the final volume will be 10 milliliters, a 1 to 20 dilution means you'll need 9.5 milliliters of fresh medium and 0.5 milliliters of resuspended cells. So I can already take this fresh medium, which is just standard DMEM growth medium. I've added to this fetal bovine serum, which provides nutrients for the cells, and pen-strep, which acts as an antibiotic to help prevent against contamination. I'm loosening the cap again, taking a fresh pipette, and adding 9.5 milliliters of this medium onto the new plate. And at this point, the trypsin will have done what it needs to do. And one way to test for that is to gently tap the side of the plate, and you can start to see the cells sliding down toward the bottom. To get them back to their original concentration, I take 9 more milliliters of growth medium, and pipette that onto the plate. And then just looking at the plate, it becomes obvious that the cells are sliding down into the medium. I do this from a few different angles to make sure all of the cells are lifted off of the plate. And then at the end, I just pipette up and down a few more times to make sure there are no more cell clumps and that they're evenly distributed inside the media. Since there is no 0.5 milliliter marking on this pipette, I take a little bit more than necessary, in this case 4 milliliters, and I'll just go ahead and pipette 0.5 milliliters onto the new plate, and the remaining 3.5 can go onto the old plate to be discarded during the cleanup step. Done with this pipette, we are now done with these cells, and this plate with the new cells I give it a quick swirl to make sure they're evenly distributed, and then this plate can go back into the incubator to be used at a later time. Now that the cells are passaged and they're back in the incubator to keep growing, it's time to clean up. So it's important to take everything back out of the hood that you brought in, and I like to double check that the tubes are all indeed sealed. And then also all of the trash needs to come out. And most importantly, the leftover cells, they can be aspirated away into the collection flask. So for that, I just use one of my old aspirating pipettes since I'm no longer worried about not contaminating these cells. Aspirate the rest of them away. And eventually they will get bleached and just poured down the sink. And all of these things that touch cells at any stage, I take them out and they get placed into a biohazard bin. And the final step to make sure everything is clean for the next tissue culture user, I take ethanol again and spray down all of the surfaces that I touched. Wipe them off. And move all of the things back where they started off. And reconnect this pipette pen to its power source. Okay, now everything has been cleaned, and the next person can come in and use the tissue culture hood after me. And that concludes the basic cell passaging procedure. So in summary, what we've done is we took the original cells on our plate, which were at about 95% confluency, washed those cells, trypsinized them, and diluted them at a 1 to 20 dilution onto a fresh plate. That gets the confluency down to about 5%, and now they'll be good for about another week before they need to be passaged again.